Hello everyone, this is Amita Gupta. Welcome you all for my third experiment of linear integrated circuit. Today we will perform the experiment of differentiator using op-amp in virtual lab. So let's start with the virtual lab. First, in Google, type virtual lab, or you can type virtuallab.ac.in. Virtual lab. In virtual lab, click on electronics and communication, scroll down, and click on basic electronics lab. In basic electronics lab, click on list of experiments and scroll down study of differentiator and integrator using operational amplifier. Integrator we have done the last experiment. Today we'll do the differentiator. This is a theory of differentiator. In brief, you can understand that output is a differentiation of the input voltage. Suppose input voltage is a sine wave, then output will be cos. If input is a square wave, okay, the differential will be in the form of spike. So this is the differentiator. Remember, in the integrator, in the feedback path, capacitor is there, but in differentiator, in the feedback path, different resistance is there. Okay, this is the theory part. Now next is procedure. Here the everything is mentioned here, how to do connections, after connection what is the step, and how to set the value of resistance, capacitance, and how to start and how to perform the experiment. I'm directly starting from the simulation, then you can easily understand it. Now, differentiator using op-amp, click on it. See here, in the right side, there is a circuit. You have to make sure the connections are perfect. So first of all, let's start with the connections. Now remember, once the connection is done, then you have to check the waveforms. For a waveform, you have to use the oscilloscope. Oscilloscope, you can watch both input as well as output. So there will be two channels, channel one for input, channel two for output. These are the control panels. Meaning you can shift the position of x-axis and y-axis. Y-axis in terms of volts per division, and in x-axis in terms of times per division. And this is to set the frequency in the amplitude of the input signal. Okay, so first start with the connection. Now channel one is connected to the input, okay, and this input is also connected here. Channel two is connected to the output, okay, where oscilloscope is connected. Now connect this capacitors here, resistor in the feedback path. Remember, in the integrator, the capacitors was in feedback and resistors were here, but in differentiator, the resistor in the feedback path. And connect this non-terminal to ground, okay. Now, after this, you have to check the connection. It is saying a right connection. Now set resistance and capacitance. Now resistance, capacitance, you can take according to your wish, okay? And then after putting the theoretical formula, you can verify whether you're getting the same answer or not, okay? So for example, I'm just taking 0.1 microfarad, or you can take any value. Now, after this, just click on this. Now you can check the output for square as well as sine wave. I'm clicking on square wave. So this is your input, square wave, and check the output. The output is in the spikes form, okay? And you can check both input and output like this. You can check the position. This is position, Y position of channel one and channel two. So you can see this is the input, that is square wave, this is the output in the spikes form, okay? Now, if you want to check for sine wave of this, okay, now again set the value of this capacitance, okay, again set the resistance, whatever value you want, click on. Now give the sine wave, okay, this is our sine wave. Now check the output, okay, now output in this form. So you, what you can do, you can just change the position also, you can like this, you can check, okay. So this is your output. And now remember, input you have given in the form of sine wave, okay? Input you have given in the form of sine wave, and output is also in the form of sine wave, okay? So you can check this, input as well as output, okay? Channel one is for input, you can like do this, and output in the form of sine wave, because cosine. Okay, now you can check, the sine wave was starting from this, the sine wave is starting, the waveform is starting from this, but cos is just opposed, because sine 0, 0, but cos 0 is 1. So you can check this. Only the difference, otherwise the waveform is, both will be sinusoidal, okay? So this is See, this is starting from this, but it is starting from this. Okay, so you can set values like this. Okay, you can set values like this. Channel 1 and channel 2. Okay, so for square wave, your output is this. For sine wave, your output is sine wave. So in this way, we have learned how to perform experiment of differentiator using virtual lab. So take care. Bye-bye. Nice to see you. Keep learning, keep sharing. God bless you.